So fill me in on the new case.
Okay. So we have a cancer patient, 9 years old. She has alveolar ribosarcoma and has been hallucinating. But it has she has no cancer in the brain, which is why it is very strange. So we need a differential diagnosis.
We do need that. Ideas, go.
Could be neurotoxicity.
Absolutely not.
No.
That was an awful idea.
It could be genetics.
That was just stupid. Don't talk again.
You know, it could be an infection from our host transplant, from our graft host disease.
That was better than their idea, so go run a tox screen and MRI. Get back to me in 1 hour.
Alveolar rhabdomyosarcoma is one of the main types of pediatric rhabdomyosarcomas commonly found in teens and young adults, normally first attacking the torso, arms, or legs. Rhabdomyosarcoma is the most common soft tissue cancer found in children. Sarcomas are cancers that develop via connective tissue in the body, such as muscles, fat, bones, membranes that line the joint, or blood vessels. RMS is a cancer made up of cells that normally develop into skeletal muscles. About 7 weeks into the development of an embryo, cells called rhabdomyoblasts, which eventually form skeletal muscles, begin to form. These are the cells that can develop RMS. Cancer results from eruption in cell cycle control. Cell division is no longer controlled by growth factors like mitosis, promoting factor, cyclins, and CDKs. Mutation in tumor suppressor genes cause uncontrolled cell growth.
Hey, how
are
you feeling?
Not too well.
Can you describe your initial symptoms for me, please?
This morning I was taking my normal medications, and right before I could finish, like, the whole room started shaking. I was having hallucinations, and then I just passed out.
Dun dun dun.
So what have we found?
Her oxygen saturation is 94%.
That's 1% off.
Her lungs aren't getting enough oxygen.
Is that what that is? I had no idea. Thank you. I didn't go to medical school, so it's good that you taught me that.
Okay.
Let's get her a chest x-ray and a pulmonary angiogram. We can rule out infections. Let's get to it, team.
The chest x-ray, the pulmonary angiogram, and the lung catheter all were clear.
Well, she obviously hasn't had sex, so that rules out any STIs.
Beep, 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 beep.
Her stab percentage dropped another point. That suggests a tumor.
Get an MRI and a heart echo.
You.
Boom, 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 boom.
We found tumoral sclerosis, and she has an extra flap in her mitral valve.
And the tumor we found in her lung passed into her heart, so we have to replace the tissue with cowpericardium.
Doctor, there's a bleed in her eye. Stop the surgery.
The cardiac tumor is benign, so it didn't cause hallucinations.
We angioed her brain and it's clear it didn't show any clots.
We wouldn't be able to find a blood clot unless we performed an autopsy.
But she's not dead.
We can change that.
Hypothermic cardiac arrest!
Perfusing the circuit. We will take 2 to 3 liters of blood out of her body and put it back in while running an MRI scan, which will reveal the outline of a blood clot. And if there is one.
Sounds fantastic.
That sounds so good.
Let's do it.
Na 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 na.
Employing therapeutic hypothermia to discover the clot is a procedure done when the clot cannot be shown on an angiogram. This entails cooling the patient body temperature down to 21 degrees Celsius, effectively stopping their heart, making them clinically dead. The doctors proceed to remove 2 to 3 liters of blood, discovering the clot while it's being repumped into the body. The blood removal and temperature cannot be held for more than 60 seconds, or the patient will suffer permanent damage.
So you're killing my daughter?
Yes. Only for a little bit, though. This will be the only way to know for sure if the blood clot is causing her issues, which it probably is.
Well, if it gives her a fighting chance...
It will give her a very good fighting chance. We removed about 3 liters of blood. Start checking the scan for the outline of the clot, and then we can begin pumping the blood back into her.
There it is! 4 millimeters lateral to the hippocampus!
Are you sure?
So sure.
Are you very positive?
Yes.
If you are very positive, then we can restart her heart. Let's remove the blood clot. It's right next to her hippocampus. We were able to remove the blood clot that was lateral to your daughter's hippocampus. She should remain asymptomatic for about another year or so.
Oh, thank God.
Jen.